to hear it now.
Jason Harrison Smith's hair is done by SWR. Okay. This is so cool because this is the second time that we've come to Westchester, Pennsylvania, thanks to the fine folks at Westchester Music, specifically David Scott, who set this whole thing up for us. We are 3/4 of Mike Keneally and Eric Goffman's. The 4/4 is sitting. Right?
Wow.
There.
MC.
Yes.
Woo. The champ.
That's right. The cool
champ.
One. Mm-hmm. But basically, you know that we're on the road, and we're playing tonight at Upstairs at Nick's in Philadelphia, so you should all go, even though it's Sunday night. And we're here because this is a clinic for SWR, and I'm in the unique position of not only being the bass player, but this fine combo that we have in the center here for you today. But also, when I'm not on the road with these guys, I work back at the factory at SWR as a product specialist, and I do some artist relations and some other stuff. So I'm in a unique position to be able to talk about our gear and tell you about how great it is and be able to play it in a practical, live situation such as this one that you're about to witness. So before I say anything else, because it's Sunday and I feel the cobwebs kind of tinkling around in my brain here, I think we're just going to play some music and then I'll try and figure out what to say after that. Except for the fact that I like SWR.
Sheltering Sky?
Yeah, sure.
You know the bass line?
No.
Okay.
It's just the... Just
thank you.
I'll take a deep long breath and let the ball run wild. Looking at the moment that
version of that song?
The D E. Don't know why.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Thank you. Pretty enough to care, happy enough to.
songs that are going to be on the next record. The first one was called Pretty Enough for Girls. When it got really slow and moody on y'all, that song was called Taster. So hopefully we're going to go back and record those songs soon because I'm having so much fun playing them. I just can't wait. Like straight into the power amp there. So I'm going to go from here to here to the cabinet. So just give me 1 second to repatch.
What is this thing called? Is it Dumbbeck?
Yeah, Dumbbeck.
Yeah, Dumbeck. I've heard Dumbeck solo.
Yes. Please. Please. Please.
We got two things.
What's that? I'm on this thing.
God, I wish.
Sound of just ever so slightly warm, overdriven power amp tubes, even in a clean signal. So it's a nice kind of a bouncy fat thing. Now the key controls here is the drive knob, which right now is at around 10 o'clock. Now if I want to push this thing into distorto land, the thing I like to do is turn the tweeter off, because there's a dial the amount of tweeter level on the back of the cabinet, just kill it. Because the kind of distortion that this thing is meant to emulate is almost kind of like that late 60s, early 70s buzz tone, before they even had tweeters, I think. First, definitely before they had tweeters and bass cabinets. And then I turn the treble up all the way to get the maximum edge on the crunch now that I've turned the tweeter down. And then I turn the drive up until it goes like this. Signal you're giving. The blend knob controls how much of that signal is present in the signal path. So right now, it's totally wide open as far as. I just turned the blend knob all the way to direct. It's just a hint of really crunchy distortion in the background, as opposed to a setting like this where you're blending a lot of that driven signal in, but the signal isn't driven to begin with. So there's a lot of different combinations of tones that you can get by dialing in this thing. It also comes with a foot switch for kicking on. Say you have the drive fully blasted. There's a foot switch that kicks off the drive and then it goes back to a clean sound, just straight off the bat. So there's a lot of things that you can do with this thing, and not a lot of people know that it exists. Which is why I'm here. Tell you about it. Yeah, check it out. And Scott and Dave would be more than happy to talk to you about it. There they are. Wherever they are. There's Scott. There's Dave. He's looming.
Yes.
I can't imagine there'd be anything you want to do with this sound. That's okay. Yeah, exactly.
There you go. I knew the words.
Do you know the words?
If I.
You can go and sing. What do you, so we're gonna play some more now. What do you want to do?
Requests?
Paranoid Android.
Ha!
Paranoid Android. Can you do? Let them.
Do you know that old song?
I didn't know. I had an idea.
Oh, I'd be scared. Let's see if I can do this.
Sure.
Hold on. What key is it in?
Starts with C, right?
Ambition is you. SWR gear or anything? Weather?
My mom and
I. No, seriously, does anybody have any questions or you can open this thing up?
You ever have any problems running directly with this?
As far as going into a mixing board?
Yeah.
No. I think the one thing that was going on, have you had problems with it?
Certain places.
As far as what?
And above as hum.
Level hum?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's you know what the trick is that in some what like I said, it puts in what it gets, it puts out what it gets in. If there's a dirty yeah, there's actually a ground lift on the back. Maybe if you on the older SM400s it didn't have a ground lift. Well, the Taylors.
Yeah.
Yeah. We don't have them on the road because we have so little space with us.
Yeah, sure.
And also, like, you know, God forbid, you know, if you're putting those things in a tight compartment, and you know.
This was mostly something I was interested in, like playing at home, you know, kicking with friends and stuff like that, rather than, you know, taking on the road. But those have, like, pickups in them? Can you?
Yeah.
Can
they have little, piezo pickups, right?
Mm-hmm. It's not like they have acoustic microphone, which more like a solid body pickup that picks up vibration.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's just this
little
tiny little bar
thing.
Yeah, right on the bridge. And the neat thing about it is that, especially with the acoustic bass, I mean, I don't know if you picked up, like, you know, Guilds or kind of the more typical acoustic electric basses or whatever you call those things. It actually, I mean, you saw how big it is.
Yeah.
It really
yeah.
resonates. You can hear it. It's like an acoustic guitar, but you can sit down and, you know, room full of your friends and, like, you know,
yeah,
light up foreign substances and we actually hear it.
I wasn't thinking about that necessarily, but you know.
Oh,
okay. It's kind of like a guitar.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they're really, really incredibly good-sounding, well-crafted instruments. I can't, you know, we're not, we were actually talking about going out and doing some stuff for Taylor. Then we saw a clinic with Lawrence Juber doing a Taylor clinic. He knew so much about every single grain of wood about those guitars. Every hour, we just felt so stupid watching them. We just decided we shouldn't do it.
I would just disintegrate the moment anybody asked me a technical question about it. It was like, it sounds good. Yeah.
The guy knew, like, what tree and what forest every single guitar was from. You know? Like, your longitude and latitude. Really kind of scary.
He's named them all. He's the tree I call Stanley is especially good for
Why did they put the hole in the funny spot?
The sound hole?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's where the knot was.
That's where Stanley's knot was. Lagerman, Bryan.
Yeah. Any other questions? Thomas? Thomas, you have any questions? Everybody, this is the most amazing tech on the entire planet.
Stop it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Billy, are we
going to
have to do this again? Yeah. Are we doing a shirt thing? Yeah. Yeah. Well,
we should do a shirt thing just because it's the most amazing set list I've ever seen. Okay. Let me go get one. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Why don't you talk about the shirt?
Let me tell you about the shirt thing. If you go over to the art illustrious and elaborately plotted merch area.
Oh, look at that.
You'll find the full of forms you can fill out to receive information about full sale, which the lovely Adrian holds up for you now. And you really want to spill it out anyway, because full sale, if you haven't heard of it, is a school in Orlando, Florida that they're this amazing institution. Richard Dawkins played there a few months ago. It was absolutely incredible. The staff is unbelievable, and the facilities are amazing, and it's everything you would ever want to know about learning how to engineer sound for albums, for film, computer graphics and gaming. It's just really impressive, and it's a wonderful place to go and learn about anything to do with modern media. And they're sponsoring our tour, and as I mentioned, if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here, so I'm very grateful to them. And you should go over, fill out a form to receive more information about full sale, and if you do, stick your form in a bucket. I'll draw a name from the bucket, and whoever gets that, whoever name I draw, we will give them a shirt that's a special Mike Keneally full sale t-shirt, of which only one is available at each show that we do. And on the back of the shirt is a blank white space where I draw the set list of that night's show. We'll have another one tonight when we play it upstairs at Nick's. We haven't given one away at a clinic yet, but as soon as we're done here, I think Dan Phelps, or Billy Bob as we affectionately call him, has been writing down everything we're playing. So I'll just scroll down the songs that we played at this clinic, and then we'll do a drawing
to give the shirt away. And the odds here are way better than
yeah,
ours.
Yeah, really good.
We're having 20 right now. So.
But we also have our own merchandise for sale over there, and I'm feeling that probably most of the people in this room have caught most of the stuff. If anything you don't have, now's the time to fill in the gaps.
And we
would appreciate it.
But, oh, the video.
Oh, yeah, we've got soaps to remember now. Anyway, and it's just fun to talk to Cammy anyway because she rocks so hard.
So let's have some more fun, and then we'll do the bucket, and then we'll do the cheesesteak.
All right. I'd like to take a request. Let's say two more requests. We haven't played a glow. I haven't played a glow in a really long time. This is Strange Impulse.
Just one more goodbye.
Hello, TV Land.